Thank you, Chancellor, and I want to echo the comments of my colleagues and thank you for your service to SUNY and to the people and the students of the state of New York, and wish you well in your future.
Thank you.
I'm going to return to probably the topic of the day, which is the Excelsior Scholarship. You may be aware that earlier this year, Senator Klein, myself, and the members of the Independent Democratic Conference put out a report on college affordability and making some recommendations on how we can broaden affordability for more students and address some of the crushing student debt that many students are carrying. And like you, we were thrilled when we saw that in the executive budget there was a proposal for closing the gap for many of these students. The program has been described by the administration as the last mile. And essentially, that's really what it is. And so as we delve into it with greater detail, I think it becomes critically important that that last mile not really become a road to nowhere. And so I think it's important that we take into consideration the flexibility that should be there and not be so rigid. You've heard from many of the members here today about the difficulty of carrying a full case of a course load of 15 credits sometimes because of personal circumstances with students who may not be college ready yet, students who may be working, all of that. But there's also the problems of sometimes the universities don't have courses that are available that meet your major
right
at the time that you need them. I'm not that old that I don't remember, registration days for, college. And when you think you have your schedule ready and you find out you've been locked out of that course. So sometimes it's beyond that dedicated student's ability to get into those 15 courses. So I would just suggest that you've heard a lot today. Perhaps that four-year degree, the 120 credits in the 4 year is a better gauge than 15 credits per semester. I think that provides the right dedication on the part of the student, and it also gives a little bit more flexibility so that we don't have students who fall out of the program, lose their eligibility, and are forced to pay the money back, because that really would be a road to nowhere. But I want to ask a couple of questions. If the goal really is to increase affordability for students, why wouldn't we just simply increase TAP for all students and increase the eligibility level for the income eligibility level, so then we would really close that gap? Would that not make more sense than creating a whole new program?
Well, I don't think I'm in a position to second guess what the thinking was on the part of the governor in plowing new territory. I will say that raising the eligibility level mm-hmm. was new for the entire country, frankly. I think attaching a condition around student commitment was new, and I will tell you, no one else, to my knowledge, in the country offers this for the baccalaureate four-year colleges. So it's a new level or new tier, and maybe all of that would have faded away if all he proposed was to increase TAP. I don't know, I can't second guess. But I do know when people ask me what's distinctive about this, one, it's the threshold, and probably Long Island or some, we know there's an income distribution across the state that's variable, but many, many, many students are gonna benefit from that. Pushing it out to our four-year campuses, it's novel, it's new, and finding some way, this is where I land, to underscore the importance of completion. That is new. We have not had that discussion. We've had a big remediation discussion. It's gone on for years. Now we're into where it really matters, completion. And so I think this new plan has fostered a discussion we had not heretofore had. But I understand. I appreciate your question.
Thank you. In the limited time, because I know there are a lot of people that have questions, there is one piece in the budget, though, that is a little confusing. The executive budget limits annual tuition and fee increases for all New York State institutions of higher ed to either $500 or three-year average of the higher ed price index, whichever is greater. Well, currently, it's 2.4%. Any new students at institutions of higher ed that increase over this threshold would not be eligible for TAP awards. So if a public institution were to raise their tuition above that, none of the students there would be eligible for TAP, but then would all of those students be eligible for the Excelsior Award?
Well, I don't know the latter part of your question, if they'd be eligible for Excelsior if they weren't eligible for TAP, but I will say that SUNY, the majority of our campuses, all of our campuses have two within the past period of 2020 have been within the HEPI index or 500, so they would not be impacted by that legislation.
Well, but what if that were to happen? I think you need to take into account what would happen to all of those students who would no longer be eligible for TAP if for some reason you raised your tuition above the...
it's a good concern.
So again, this is a wonderful concept. I think we all agree, you know, that last mile is critically important, but we need to really put a lot of thought into making sure that we don't unintentionally pull the rug out from underneath students and the institutions itself. Thank you.
Thank you.